Okay, I took one box of Fleischmann's Simply Homemade Pretzel Creations baking mix. And what comes with it is a bag of pretzel mix, some Fleischmann's Rapid Rise yeast. It says to dump the mixture in the bowl and add the yeast, and then we're going to add the hot water and the oil. The kit comes with some baking soda, which you'll dip your pretzels in after you've formed them and let them rise. And it also comes with a thing of pretzel salt. Okay, so you're going to add 1 tablespoon of oil. So I've got my very warm 3/4 cup of water here. And I'm going to go ahead and add my tablespoon of oil to it. And I'm just using Walmart vegetable oil. So then we're going to add that to the mix. And what you're going to do is you're just going to stir that. You'll stir it till it gets stiff, so it mixes up to a form a ball. A dough ball here, and you just put that in a bowl and let that rise. It should, after about 25 minutes, it should double in size. So we're just going to cover that. Okay, it says 25 minutes on the box, but we're at high elevation, so it took we're at about an hour for it to double in size. Okay, I'm doing it in this my other kettles, my good kettles, because it doesn't have a coating on it. That's the way the kettles are made. If you put this baking soda into one of the cheaper pans, it's going to be corrosive. It's going to ruin your pan. So you don't want to do that. You want to bring this to a boil, and it's going to be really foamy. So you need to bring it to a boil because you're going to dip those pretzels in it and then put them on the baking sheet. So I'll stir this up. I'll bring that to a boil. Okay, so there's my dough ball, and I'm gonna take a pizza cutter here, and I'm gonna divide this into sections. Now I want my pretzels to be a little bit bigger than what the recipe calls for. So I'm going to make 6 bigger pretzels. So you can roll it out if you want, but all you do is roll your dough out into a long rope. And you can just twist it. If you get really good at it, you can roll it. And I want my pretzels to be a little puffy, so I'm not going to go too big. And what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and place these on a pan here. So, now on the back of the box, it will show you to make a U. So you'll make a U like this. Make it just a little bit bigger. You'll make a U and you'll cross it. And then you'll twist it, and then you come down. And then there's your pretzel. Just push those in and you have your pretzel. So again, you make your U. Bring this out a little bit. You make your U. You cross over, you twist, and you bring it down. And just push it in. It does not have to be perfect. And as you see, you just lay it on the pan there. Roll it out. And as you get better with it, if you let your dough rise for, probably 3 or 4 hours, not going to hurt anything. You'll actually get bigger pretzels. So you make your U, you cross over, you twist, and bring down. And you know, if it's not quite right, put your two fingers in, push down here, and spread out. And then you can make your little... See how you do that? And you can push in really good, too. Because you don't want them to come apart in the baking soda solution. So if you're not sure whether they're going to stay, just pinch them. Just pinch it, and it's not going to hurt anything to pinch those corners down in. It's not going to hurt nothing to make sure that it's good and tight there. And it doesn't have to be perfect. Cross it, twist it, bring it down. And then if you want to spread it out, you can spread your pretzel out. You can form it. You can even push it on the middle and on the ends to make sure that it doesn't come apart. And no, the only place I've ever made pretzels is at home. I have not done this professionally, obviously. Make the U, cross over, twist, bring it down. And you can push it in the middle if you like. Form those in the middle. You can make long pretzels. You can make pretzel rolls. You can make thick pretzels so you can cut them in half and use them as sandwiches. Now this thing says it makes 9 pretzels. This box. And this is from Walmart. So, and that's the reason I got it, to show you how to do something you can buy from Walmart. Now, I have a pretzel recipe that I will put, a German pretzel recipe, that I'll put at the bottom of this YouTube video. And it's a homemade recipe, so I'll put that down. But if you don't want to go through all that, and you just want to do it from a mix, it's just a simple $2, and I think it was $2.97. Something like that. Now this is going to be a little bit smaller because it was the small piece of dough. Make your U, cross over, twist, bring it down. It's that simple. It's that simple. So there they are. There's nothing fancy about them. You can let those rise. You can let those rise and double if you want. But once you put them in, you'll see, once you put them in the baking soda, the hot baking soda water, they're going to puff up. So, all right, we're going to clean that up, and we're going to get ready to, we're going to turn this back on. We're going to bring that back up to a boil. And then you just heard the beep of the oven go off. So our oven's at 400 degrees. I turned that off because it was boiling a second ago. So when we come back, we're going to dip these and go ahead and bake them. Now I just switched pans because I'm not going to be able to reach down in. So I just switched the pans to my cast iron skillet there because I'm going to use some tongs to do this because it was just too deep. I couldn't get into the pan and get it back out. Okay, so this is ready to dip one. We're going to dip, and you let it in there for like 15 seconds. And then place it on your cookie sheet. And before you bake it, we're going to We're going to add the pretzel salt. Don't leave it too long. Pull it out. Place it on your cookie sheet. Doesn't matter if you squeeze it. You're trying to win no pretzel beauty contest. See, there's just no way I could have got that out of that deep pan I put it in. Because it's that baking soda solution with 6 cups of water. Okay, I forgot to count. See, I want them really thick. Now, it doesn't matter if it gets foamy like that. You can turn it down a little bit. It's supposed to get foamy. Can't even see it anymore. Two more. Turn it down so I can see it. And again, I'm not counting. I'm just a couple seconds. 15 seconds is what it recommends. Bigger the pretzel, the longer you might leave it in. But don't leave it in more than 30 seconds or so. There's no need. Okay, the last little tiny one. Okay. So there's my 6 pretzels, and I'll show them to you. Let me shut this off. Always make sure you use a pot holder, even though it really wasn't that hot. Okay, what we're going to do is bring these pretzels over here, and we're going to salt them. Now, the salt that came with it, let me go ahead and cut that open and show you that salt. If you're only going 6, it's going to be enough. Dish here. They only give you about not even a quarter of an ounce. But go ahead and salt your pretzels. Now if you're going to put cinnamon and sugar on them when you get them out of the oven, then you don't want to salt them. And you see, I like a lot of salt, so there's no way that is going to be enough. So I have other pretzel salt. I'm going to go ahead and really coat them. Because I'm going to be eating these and drinking some beers, so of course I am. So I like a lot of salt on them. And if you're making these for a party and you're going to have beer and so forth, you can put anything on them. You can top these with Parmesan cheese. You can top them with cinnamon and sugar. You can just not top them at all and then have dips to dip them in, like a caramel dip or so forth and so on. Now these are going to go in the oven. It says on the package, 10 to 12 minutes until they're golden brown. So we're going to go ahead and stick them in. Put my tripod back here. We're going to set our timer. For 10 minutes so we can check on them. Now you need to get that solution out of your kettle, whatever kettle you're using. You need to get that baking soda solution out, because that baking soda solution will ruin a pot or pan, and it's pretty much going to ruin almost anything, but it's not going to bother this cast iron. You know, it says don't use them on anodized kettles, and I was going to use it on that anodized kettle. And I decided not to, for the fact that it was too deep, and also that it was anodized. So, and what I'm going to do here is I'm going to wipe that out with a towel. And you'll see that it leaves residue. So you want to go ahead and wash this with hot soapy water as soon as possible. But you can't make a pretzel without a baking soda wash solution, because it's not going to work. It'll just turn out to be bread. The key is the baking soda. Alright, so I washed my cast iron skillet here. Get all the soap out of it. And we're going to go ahead and put that on the burner now. We're going to heat that up and re-season our skillet. And when you re-season your anything cast iron, we'll go ahead and wipe off all the excess. Bring it up to temperature. Let all the moisture go out of it. I've already got another video up here for this, but I always tell you again, all that moisture out. And it doesn't take but about 30 seconds to do this. Then you put vegetable oil, any type of oil, whatever oil you want in it. Get some more clean napkins. I use napkins for everything. And go ahead and wipe that whole skillet. Handle, sides. You don't have to do the bottom, but I will after I take it off the burner, I'll do the bottom. Let that come up to a little bit more temperature. Get some more dry napkins. Give it just a couple seconds because it's going to get pretty hot. Don't burn yourself. Go ahead and shut that off now, the burner. And you just re-season your skillet. You don't want to leave that baking soda solution in any type of skillet. Now I'm going to go ahead and do the bottom with what was on this napkin and set it back there. And you don't want to leave that baking soda solution in any type of pan, because it will eat the finish off of those cheaper pans. It will ruin an anodized pan, and it will also ruin a cast iron skillet if you ain't careful. So there's basically nothing that the baking soda won't ruin. It's just some are more susceptible than others, like anodized or those cheap discount department store pans. You know what I'm talking about. Alright, so when that timer goes off, it's got 7 minutes. We're going to check our pretzels. We're going to check it now. Turn the light on in the oven. Look at them. Look at them bad boys. Yep. German pretzel tonight. So to quick recap why those pretzels are baking. You have your mix, which you get at Walmart, your Fleischmann's Pretzel Creations mix. It comes with a flour mix. Comes with a packet of Fleischmann's Rapid Rise. It comes with a little thing of pretzel salt, which ain't enough to shake a stick at. You can see. So if you like salt, you're going to have to get you some pretzel salt. And it comes with a baking soda solution that you put with 6 cups of water. And in less than an hour, of course, we're at high elevations, and I let my pretzel dough rise for an hour. So there's no way that would have been risen at 25 minutes. Now, maybe it was because the yeast was a little older, but the yeast doesn't expire until November 12th, 2015, so you know, the yeast is good, but we're at high elevation here. We're at 2,100 feet, so maybe that had something to do with it. But usually, every time we make something with dough, we got to let it rise double. We got 3 minutes left on the timer. We're going to check them out again. They're coming along nicely. Now, I made them a little thicker. So we're a little thicker pretzels, because it says it'll make 9 and I only made 6. So we're a little thicker and we're at 2,100 feet. So it's going to take a little longer. But I set it at 10 minutes. They say 10 to 13 minutes, something like that, on the back of the box. It says 10 to 12 minutes, or until golden brown. That way they covered her ass. Now when you take these out, don't just dig right into them, because the inside's going to be piping hot. You need to let them stand for a couple minutes. You need to let them cool, preferably on a wire rack, if you've got one. Take them off the pan and let them cool for, a good 4 or 5 minutes. You don't want to dig into those bad boys too soon, because you will burn your little face off. I'll be right back in a couple minutes. Okay, we got a minute left on the original timer. Now, if you don't have a wire rack to let your pretzels cool, you can always put them on, you know, one of these broiler racks that come with every stove. So, I'll go ahead and grab that. Coming up on the 13-minute mark. Okay, we're coming up on 16 minutes, and they're looking perfect. When it goes off, I think 16 minutes is where I want to be. But again, remember, if you're at lower elevations, it's going to be quicker. It's going to be quicker on your rise. It's going to be quicker on your bake. Almost ready to go off. Grab a pot holder here. See, they're looking absolutely perfect. Now, I did not spray that pan with any Pam or anything, because I kind of like it a little brown on the bottom. All right, that is 16 minutes. So I'm going to shut my oven off. You can see. They come off even if you don't spray them pretty good. So we're going to let those cool on this rack. And move my camera. There's that little one. I'm just going to leave that sit there. I won't burn the counters up anymore, and I already have. Alright, so there's the pretzels. It's simple, it's easy. It's Fleischmann's Simply Homemade Baking Mix Pretzel Creations. Just add water and oil in less than an hour, it says. Ours took us about 15 minutes to mix, an hour to rise, and 16 minutes to bake. So for us, you're looking at about an hour and a half or so. But you can slice into that bad boy. See, the bottom got a little brown, but that's the way I like it. You can slice into that bad boy, put some ham on there, some cheese, mustard. You can eat it like that. We're going to let it cool a second, and then I'm going to split one open, and we're going to try it. Okay, the pretzels have been cooling for about 5 minutes, and we took a bread knife and sliced into it. Now, you can see what I'm talking about. I don't know if you can see that steam. That's after setting for 5 minutes. So it is hot. Now, that's why I'm telling you, do not get them out of the oven and launch your little mouth into one, because you're going to regret it. See, that's after 5 minutes. So after 5 minutes, you can slice one open. You can do what I'm getting ready to do right here. Getting ready to take some. We're getting ready to take a little deli ham. Look at that bad boy. Fold that over. We're going to take some French's honey mustard. Now that, my friends, is Pretzel 101. That, my friends, is Tom's Manly Meals. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. That is unbelievable. Oh wow. That's gonna be good for our little broadcast tonight. Isn't that something? Take some Black Forest ham. Some German mustard. Well, French's honey mustard is pretty damn good. Launch your mouth into that little baby. It's nice and warm. Oh, wow. Oh, yeah. You know what? Usually I only take a bite or so. And then I go off the camera. But that, my friends. That, my friends, is a pretzel sandwich right there. Shit. Alright. For Tom's Manly Meals, I'm talking Tom Moore. Good luck to you. Wow. That's some damn good fucking shit right there. Chase that with a fucking beer. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.